Good afternoon, Blacker buddies. Off to a little bike show thing at Warmer Green today with Brian Keith. And Jim, is that car not looking what he was doing? Nearly edge you there, Keith. I bet the little Porsche, whatever it is behind us, is going to come belting past us up the hill on the way to Nebworth in a minute. Can guarantee it. That Norton sounds nice, doesn't it? It's like it's just come out of the showroom. Done a good job there, Keith. Looks beautiful, mate. Here comes that Porsche. What did I tell you? Wanker. Should make a bit of noise going through Nebworth High Street. Little bit of, I should have Brian in front because he's bound to start revving it up. I'm not sure if the actual camera picks up all the noise of these four bikes. It sounds pretty good. We should overtake that Porsche. There's a bit of what's going on down here. Lots of police. Always something interesting on a Sunday afternoon. Van crash, car crash, say an Audi. Audi into the back of a transit. Let's get right in front, see if you... Rev. Here he goes. He had to do it. It sounds nice over right when you do that. Brian's only got one eye, so I'm not sure if you can judge. sorry Brian. There's a few bikes, a few old cars.
Where's the bar?
You look like that fan has reversed out of that driveway.
Yeah.
Coming up there fast and flirty, aren't they?
I'm out of the back, filming. So now we have Jim up front, Brian behind him, Keith behind him. We've got Ian come along with a ride with us on his Triumph. And me at the back filming. think it must be the quietest bike in the pack. The pipes that Ian's got on his are the ones similar to that. One in front of me. Pretty much the same as Jim's BSA ones, really. You know, the old T120 pipes. Pretty good to have five British bikes out for a ride. Let's just hope the weather holds up. it didn't say it was going to rain, so there was a toss up whether should I bring out the XS 650 or the Triumph? I'm glad I bought the Triumph out now. They definitely sound nice. I'm not sure if the camera picks up, but you can hear from back here, so you can hear, a drone. A drone of all the bikes in front, yeah. None of that wingy, dingy, whiny noise that the plastic-covered go-faster bikes make. They certainly turn a few heads as you drive past. This is where I get kicked to death by the horse after this lot started it. I like the way all of them shut their throttles off as they go past the horse. Sensible bikers. For loudness though, out of all the bikes, I think it's a toss up between the Norton and Keith in front. The Norton just beats him to the post, I reckon. Yeah, go for the Norton being the loudest one. Probably the nicest tone as well. We have a Facebook page called Stevenage Cruisers, but we don't really update it that much, really. Should do more often. Yeah, find out when we're all out and about. Or maybe in the videos, I should maybe put down the next time we're out, or the next day we're out. Leave it in the comments when we're out and about. So if you got bikers want to join out with us. Don't normally do much more than 50 mile an hour max, I suppose. Well, sometimes I do, but very rarely. No point in thrashing the guts out of these old bikes unless you really have to. You don't want to go much faster than that round lanes anyway on these old things. No point in buggering up what you spent years putting back right, is there?
Seems the people take too long to serve in that pub, so we're going to find another one, which is probably quicker. Hey.
I don't know if you heard that, a stone just fucking flew up off Brian's tyre, pinged off me crash helmet. Thank you, Brian. I bet it was a massive fly or something. I used to have the, you know, the choke lever on the handlebars. I had one on it last week. And while I was cleaning out the carbs the other day, I found the choke plunger attachment, which was on the new carbs that I bought. So I took the old cable system out and put like the original plunger, you know, like the little metal lever that you push down. It's much easier, less cables under the tank. Just press it down, start it up, turn it off, and job done. No messing around with the twisting the lever and getting in the right place and all that kind of stuff. I had to go to the old one. I've got a sonic cleaner at home as well, so I put the carbs that I had around the garage, I put them through the cleaner. It's pretty amazing. After a couple of hours at 80 degrees with a carb cleaner fluid in it, how well they come out. They look quite nice. I think in the winter, when next winter, I think I'll just take all the bits that I could fit into that sonic cleaner, take them all off of this bike and put them through that sonic cleaner, clean them up, and then put them all back on, all nice and sparkling. But what's the bettings, by the time I get around to do that, I can't be arsed. Thinking about restore. I've got another XS650 around the garage in bits. Thinking about restoring that as well. Just been pondering over that for the last two or three days. And I've probably got most of the bits. It's a 1979 model. I think it's a special, XS650 special. I think probably once I got my mate's bike out of the garage, the FJ1200, I think I'll start collecting up all the bits and pieces of the XS650, which are laying around everywhere, and just like basically throw it together and see what I need. Engine wise, I'll probably need a bottom end for it. I've got most of the, well, I've probably got all the top end. Just need just a bottom end really. Probably pick that up easy enough. So now if I pick another whole engine up, I'm only going to strip it down completely and rebuild it with new parts, and that's going to cost me a fortune. Not sure if I'm going to actually restore it to original either. Maybe make it look a bit different, have it a little bit different maybe, I don't know. Have to see when it gets to that stage. If I do restore it to original, I'll probably take a lot longer to do than I did my other one. And get every bit, every detail right, you know, so it looks like it come, you know, it's come off the showroom. Or just complaining about the potholes and stuff, they've just driven straight over one. I think four out of the five of us have got bad backs. Oh, poor badger. Dead badger in the road there. There you go with the road humps. I wonder if they're going to Hooks Cross. That's a no. Well, maybe. Aston. Blimey, I didn't know you can get to Aston that way. Oh, this is where we are.